Hey, what's up guys? It's Ivan, and in this video I want to show you how to create the new Google Ads Demand Gen campaign, which is basically an upgraded discovery campaign, if you guys are familiar with that, where basically Google Ads will show your ad, what you set, on all Google-owned properties. So YouTube, Google, Gmail, anything like that. And for those of you that are familiar with the discovery ads that they had before, here are some of the differences. Rather the changes, the upgrades. So the biggest ones to me are now that you can create video ads in addition to just image ads, and that you can place them in YouTube Shorts and in-stream videos as well. I have been using Google Ads for the past 7 years, and so in this video, I want to show you how to create these new demand gen campaigns so that you can profit and maximize the growth of your business. So let's get into it. The first thing you guys want to do is head over to ads.google.com and sign in or sign up if you don't have an account. Once you do that, click on this little plus sign over here under campaigns and click on new campaign. You can select any of these options that work for you, that are your goal. For example, website traffic, sales, if you have conversion tracking set up, leads, if you want to generate leads. I'm going to click create a campaign without a goals guidance so that you see all the options available over here. So I do have videos on these as well. I have a search campaign video, display campaign, shopping campaign, video. In this video, we're going to focus on demand gen over here. So I'm going to click on that. And you do ideally want to have conversion tracking set up. So if you don't have that up yet, make sure you set that up following my conversion tracking video. But we're going to click on continue over here. And the setup for this is pretty simple. We're going to go from top to bottom. So let's suppose I want to promote my website for this campaign, ivanmana.com, where I offer a free guide. So I'm going to type in here, Ivan Mana free guide, demand generation, I'm guessing. And so here you would set your goal. So if you have conversion tracking set up, absolutely have conversions over here so that Google can show your ads to people most likely to convert. If you're brand new, you don't have anything set up yet, you can go ahead and select clicks so that you will just focus on getting as many clicks as possible so that you get those conversions, all right? So over here, you can set a budget. So let's suppose I want to spend $25 per day. You can set a start and end date. You don't have to do all the Google Ad recommendations, by the way, do whatever you're comfortable with. Now here you have the location settings. So a demand gen campaign works a little bit differently from a display, YouTube, or search campaign in that in this campaign type, your ad groups are like the different campaigns because that's where you would be able to set your targeting at each different ad group. And so Google kind of wants to create this big campaign for you and then test different locations and different targeting options for each ad group, where you would normally have to just create different campaigns for that. But in this case, they're allowing you to set it at the ad group level. So you can keep it at the ad group level, or if you want, if you just want one campaign with one targeting, you can check mark that on, and then you can come in here and just select your locations. So for example, you can say Canada and then United States. For example, then we can scroll down, you can select the languages. So if your ad will be in English, I do suggest selecting English so that you show your ad to people who speak English, right? You can also set devices, set ad schedule and campaign URL options if you have some sort of third-party tracking integration set up. So everything looks good here. We're going to go to ad group one. Now I'm going to leave this off for now. We're first going to create an audience and then we're going to name our ad group. Let me hide that over there. So you can create an audience. The difference between this campaign type and let's say display campaign type is that you can't choose where you want your ads to show, right? Because this will show it on all Google properties. So that's already kind of a given. So the only thing you can set here is the types of people you want to target. So over here, you can click on new segment and you can target people that searched for specific terms, browse certain websites, use certain apps. You can do this sort of targeting. If you have a remarketing list, you can target people that interacted with your business by clicking here and selecting either your YouTube users, if you have a YouTube channel, or any one of these. But like I said, you do need to have a remarketing list set up yet to use these, so it won't be very effective. However, if you do have Google Analytics, you can select this option and target people that interacted with your site if you have tracked them using Google Analytics. You can also set a lookalike audience. So this is really cool, just like with Facebook, the lookalike ads, where you can select your remarketing list, which we don't have in this case, and then Google will try to target people that are similar to this remarketing list. So really cool, works just like with Facebook ads. Keep your eyes open. I'm gonna create a Google Ads remarketing 2024 video, but for now we don't have anything. So we're just gonna close out of that. And of course, last but not least, if you don't have any of these, you can select specific audiences. So you can come in here and you can select people based on their in market, which means people are looking specifically to buy something. They're in the market for something, their life events, like their marriage, moving, job change, anything like that. Detailed demographics in terms of parental status, education, any of that. Affinity, so things that people are interested in. Think maybe sites that people visit but aren't necessarily looking to buy anything. So you can target people based on these. So in my case, if I'm promoting my affiliate marketing guide, maybe I want to target the finance section. So people that are looking to make money, to build wealth, things like that. So I can click on this little down arrow over there to see more options. So maybe avid investors. Okay, so let's suppose on Google, on all the Google owned platforms, I want to focus on avid investors. That's what I would do here. But I could also come in here and I can go into browse and I would go into, sorry, this demographics isn't here. It's going to be over here. So I can target specific genders and specific ages. So let's suppose I want to target people from, so knowing my YouTube audience, it's from roughly 30 to 40 years old. That's the bulk of my, or like 25 to 40, right? So I'm going to say 25 to, let's say 44, because that's, for example, where the bulk of my YouTube audience is, and it's mostly males. So what I can do is I can just remove these, and that way my ads will be shown mainly to males ages 25 to 44, for an example, because that's the audience that generally converts best for me. Whatever your metrics are, whatever works best for you, you can do that there. You can also add exclusions. You can say, hey, I don't want people that are blah, 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 people that maybe have already bought from me, or maybe people that have seen my YouTube video on Google Ads, I don't want to target those. So you can do that by clicking on this exclusions tab over here, all right? So that looks good. Let's see this again. We're targeting avid investors. So let's say avid investors, okay? And then we can say male 25 to 44, right? That's the target for this specific campaign or this specific ad group. So you can create different ad groups and test different interest groups, test different demographics, things like that. So you're gonna click on save. So that is what this is. So over here, we can name it the same thing. We can say avid investors, male 25 to 44. And that way at a glance, right, when we have many different ad groups, we can take one glance at it and know exactly what this ad group is composed of. So that's how this works. You can edit this by clicking on the pencil icon or removing it entirely or duplicating it and then saying, hey, I want to create a copy of this, but I want to change the age from 44 to 65 and see what works better. Okay, so you can do that over here. Just come in here, change that, change the title, and then boom, it's, you're gonna have two different basically audience groups that you're gonna be testing. If that's how you do it though, I do suggest that you duplicate the ad group, right? So don't just do it here because then it'll be part of the same ad group. You wanna create a different ad group and then create the audience there, but that's how this works. Next, you have optimized targeting. If you select this option, then Google Ads will show your ads to people that are similar to what you selected here. So we selected avid investors, males 25 to 44. Google might expand the reach a little bit, maybe show it to some younger males, some older males, and maybe somebody who's not just an avid investor, okay? So if you wanna be strict and careful with your spend, I suggest taking this off for now, at least when you're starting out. Again, add URL options is if you have conversion tracking set up with a different third-party platform. If you don't, just don't worry about it. So we're gonna go to ad one, okay? So this is the ad. So you can create a single image ad, for example, if I just wanna promote my site, or I can create a video ad. So if I want to intrigue people with my Google Ads video, for example, I would select the video ad. I'm gonna go with single image ad here and just show you how this goes, but the idea would be the same with video ad, just that instead of an image, you're gonna select your video. That's it, all right? So let's click on single image ad. Again, I'm gonna keep the ad name open for now until we actually select the images and select all the details. And then over here, you'll be able to see what it's going to look like. So you can click on images. They have free stock images, which is really cool. So let me type in affiliate marketing, for example, or you know what, let me type in make money online so it can be a little bit more intriguing to people. So this looks kind of cool, make money online, doesn't look too fishy, too fake. So we can click on that, and then of course they have, Google has different dimensions. So you wanna come in here and just make sure that for every dimension you select, it the main message fits, right? So here's the 1.1, we wanna make sure that message is there. The 4.5, we wanna make sure that make money online is there, right? So something like that. And then you click select. You can also add more images if you like. So let's find something else that's not as fishy. or not as cheesy, right? So this is like, you know, money coming out. It's okay. We can test it though. So let's click that. Make sure we get the main points here. You know, the money coming out. That's kind of the main idea here. The money on the computer. And then select three ratio and then click save. Okay, so we have that. You do have to add a logo. So a logo to your site, to your business. And then here's what it would look like, by the way, right? So on Discover, Gmail, app, that's what it's gonna look like. So it looks pretty cool. I like it. And then let's add a logo. I'm gonna click add here. Now I'm gonna put in my website here just because I don't have a logo in front of me. And then let's just use this for simplicity. Just to make things easy, I'm gonna just select that, select this. But obviously you would just, you can just upload your own logo right over here. I'm gonna click save just for simplicity. And then over here you can add the headline, right? So get your free affiliate marketing guide. And that's 39 characters, you have a limit of 40. You can add more headlines if you want. So let's say something like learn how to make money online today. And then it's gonna say right there, right? And then you have the description over here. So we can say, get your free affiliate marketing guide and learn how you can start making money online. Let me add another one. Let me say, we earn money while we sleep and want to show you how to do it too. So you can do something like that. You can include a call to action. Let's say learn more. Business name is Yvonne Mana Inc. And then this is what it's going to look like. So on Discover, on YouTube, and on Gmail. And this is the Gmail open. I don't know how to toggle it to make sure like so that you see what it looks like closed. But there is sometimes an option to see it like before somebody actually opens it. Maybe if we come over here, no. Yeah, so that's what it'll look like when somebody actually opens your email, right? Discover is only on mobile devices, but here you have YouTube home feed. It's gonna look like that, okay? And that's what your ad looks like. So it looks pretty cool. Now you can also enter your URL. So where do you wanna ultimately take people to? Well, it's gonna be my site, yvonnemana.com. You can add a different URL for mobile. And basically just go up here and make sure everything is good. A logo is important because over here, as you can see, it looks pretty ugly right there, right? So make sure you upload a good image of your logo. And then over here, we can just say our message is about free guide and make money online. So that's our title. So we can reference it when, if we have many different ads, we'll know what this ad is about, right? So the ad strength is good here. You can add more images, more descriptions, more headlines, and Google will mix and match them and show you the best one. Make sure you do have conversion tracking set up though, because if you don't, this whole process will be pretty useless. All right, because then it'll just be showing ads to people that maybe click on it more, but that doesn't mean it's more sales. Sales is the most important thing. You can also click on review combinations and placements. Okay, and then here's the Gmail close. We finally found it. So that's what it's gonna look like right there. But again, the logo is pretty important, right? So just make sure it looks good. And that looks good. So we're gonna go to review, make sure everything here is fine. Click on more details, make sure you got the devices, you got the schedule, you got everything as you want it to be, and then click on publish campaign. And that is pretty much it. So now the campaign will be under review. Let me quickly show you how to access it, how to edit it. So if you click on campaigns over here, you should see it right here. It's got this little discovery or demand gen icon right there to signify what campaign type it is. If you want to change your campaign settings, you just click on this little gear icon over here and you can change the settings over here, okay? Then from here, you can also click on your specific ad group or your ad, and you can make changes for any of those as well. However, you can also just click on that campaign and then you'll see the ad over here. Let's go back into campaigns. Let's click on this one over here. If you want to make any changes to the ad group, you can either go back to the campaign tab and click on this little gear icon, like I mentioned, and then just select ad group over here. Or if you click on this ad group, you'll be able to change the ad here by clicking on ads or click on audience segments. And then from here on, you'll be able to adjust your audiences, right? Whichever ones you set over here. So you click on edit audience over here, or sorry, it's loading a little bit. So you can edit demographics, edit exclusions, edit audience segments, or edit audiences over here. So you can do all that here. And let me just last but not least show you what the columns are. So you have your cost, how much you spent over here. You have your impressions, how many times your ad has been seen, how many clicks it got, what the CTR is, so the clicks divided by impressions, how many conversions you got, and all these different columns here. You can adjust your columns by clicking on columns, clicking on edit, that's our default column set, and then choosing whatever you want to add. So over here, if you want to add viewable impressions, if you want to add results, results value, performance, engagements, views, right, whatever. There's just too many to kind of go over and explain each and every one of them to you, but you can look at what you like, whatever you need, and just add whatever you like. So budget changes, if I want to track my budget changes, I can add it here. As you can see, it's added, and then I can drag it to the top if I want. The most important ones for sure though are CTR, clicks, impressions, and conversions. Those are the most important ones. What you want to do with your columns after that is up to you, okay? But the conversions, absolutely imperative. And then you can save and apply, and it's going to save your default column set. And now you will be able to see your budget changes over here. All right, and that's it. That's how you create this demand gen campaign. Congratulations. If you guys found value in this video, I do invite you to check out my YouTube channel at youtube.com/YvonneManna, where I have a lot of different videos, you know, over 600 videos on various different online marketing tools, Facebook, Google Ads, Microsoft Ads, how to make money online, things like that. As well as if you want to get started with affiliate marketing, I do invite you to check out my website at YvonneManna.com, where I offer you a free affiliate marketing guide, as well as training courses where you can go into very thorough detail, very, very thorough detail on any of these, whatever you want to learn more about, and master any one of them. And that is all for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.